What's good, y'all? It's your hostess, Great Meme Central, here back with another video. And today, we are going to be ranking every month's major holiday from January to December. And some of the holidays in this mix, I'm not going to cover all the holidays. I know that some months, like January, it has Martin Luther King. In November, they have Veterans Day. So I will not be covering those, even though those are major, those are not the major draw to the holiday. So without further ado, let's get to the video. Start us off, the first holiday that we got here on the list is January, when it's a major holiday, as everybody knows, and actually coming up within about a month, is New Year's Day, which is, I mean, it's a cool holiday for the moment. I mean, there's the build-up from after Christmas to New Year's Day. You know, you got that buffer in there, which is kind of like the, I don't know, kind of part of the year, as everybody calls it. And then, like, it's an alright day if you have, like, maybe a girl to kiss at midnight, but other than that, there ain't really much else to New Year's Day. Once you get past midnight, then it's just a normal day outside of the clubs wanting to charge double, triple the damn cover just to get in. It gets crazy on damn New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. Sometimes even 10 times the normal cover, because the club that I go to, it's normally $10 to get in, but if you get there at the gate on New Year's Eve, it's $100 to get in. Yeah, it's crazy. It is upcharging like crazy on damn New Year's. But that's, to me, it's a good holiday. And up next for number two, we have Valentine's Day, which is also another kind of one of the most unliked holidays, because it's like a holiday where if you're with somebody, good. If you're not, you're just with people that are with somebody. And if you are with somebody, you may have memories come up in your Google or your Snapchat or your iCloud of memories of like past people that you dated or married to, or all kind, or some kind of friends benefits situation, whatever you got going on. And so, like, it's like just a very holiday. I mean, if you're with somebody, it's good. If not, it's kind of secondary holiday. In February, it's President's Day, but nobody really cares about that besides the day off. Although, if you are in school, you do get a nice 4 to 6 days off, depending on your district, around like the week of Valentine's Day. So, yeah, you do get that. But other than all, it's pretty meh. And up next, we have St. Patrick's Day from March, the third entry to the list. And with St. Patrick's Day, I mean, it's for the most part a good holiday. I mean, like, if you're drinking, heck yeah, you go to an Irish pub, yeah, they got stuff going on there. You know, you made some corn tea. I know some places, especially where there's a lot of redheads at, especially the man redhead chicks, bro. Ooh, man, some of the redheads, you might be able to bag one that night. Who knows what will go down on the game night like that. But it's a pretty good holiday in there. It's not a fairly recognized one, but you know, some people celebrate it and stuff, especially if you're of Irish heritage. But you know, it's decent. It's all right though. And for our fourth entry on the list, we have Easter coming in for April. And Easter, it's pretty much, if you're a Christian, it's like one of the most Christianist holidays of the year, almost beating out, if not, it does beat out Christmas as the most religious holiday of the year. And that day, you know, everybody goes to church, they all nice dressed up, and then afterwards you go, you just eat a ham, some mac and cheese, and some greens, some collard, collard greens, look at some, cornbread. So you know, most people have a nice little feast going on after that. And especially some of the main women that go to the church, but some of the dresses, ooh, bro, I love seeing them girls in some of those dresses. So all in all, Easter, it's a pretty good one. I know some people's drama, they may give them the Good Friday off, which is that Friday before Easter Sunday off, so that's nice. Other than that, it's a pretty good holiday. And our sixth entry on this list is Juneteenth, with June. And this is a brand spanking new holiday that President Biden just signed into law 2 years ago, back in 2021. So, like, it is still a brand new one. if now what I said, but it says that if Trump didn't plan his rally in 2020, nobody would have never known about Juneteenth, except for if you're black and you had that one aunt or that one grandma that is heavily into black culture. That's the only way you would know about Juneteenth. Other than that, like had Trump planned his rally the week before or the week after that back in 2020, none of us probably knew what the hell Juneteenth was. But that's a nice holiday that you get a nice little 3-day weekend in there, and it's also kind of builds you up to the next holiday, which is only about 2 weeks away-ish. And that is, oh yeah, but before I get to that, also June is typically the month where a lot of colleges and a lot of high schools get out, so it's the official start to summer break, and just a whole lot of other good stuff that be going on in June. But yeah, it's pretty alright. It's not one of the best holidays, but it's definitely a good one. And our sixth entry on this list is Juneteenth, mid-June. And this is a brand spanking new holiday that President Biden just signed into law 2 years ago, back in 2021. So, like, it is still a brand new one. If now what I said about this is that if Trump didn't plan his rally in 2020, nobody would have never known about Juneteenth, except for if you're black and you have that one aunt or that one grandma that is heavily into black culture. That's the only way you would know about Juneteenth. Other than that, like had Trump planned his rally the week before or the week after that back in 2020, none of us probably knew what the hell Juneteenth was. But that's a nice holiday that you get a nice little 3-day weekend in there, and it's also kind of builds you up to the next holiday, which is only about 2 weeks away-ish. And that is, oh yeah, but before I get to that, also June is typically the month where a lot of colleges and a lot of high schools get out, so it's the official start to summer break, and just a whole lot of other good stuff that be going on in June. But yeah, it's pretty alright. It's not one of the best holidays, but it's definitely a good one. Up next, we have the 4th of July, aka Independence Day, aka America's birthday. And this holiday is just crazy year in, year out. For starters, if you have people that are vets or animals that go see the vet, of course they don't like it because the fireworks are going off, but the firework displays on 4th of July, they be going crazy every year. And also, if you live close to the beach or any body of water, of course you get all the baddies and bikinis, and they getting drunk, so you know they start taking whatever clothing they got off, so you know it's just a whole big old party and stuff. It's a lot of DUIs. Don't drink and drive if you ever, and on any of the other holidays, definitely don't drink and drive. Find an Uber, Lyft, taxi, have a Didi, and find some other way to safely get home. But like, I mean, you got the baddies going on, bro. I mean, you have the parties. Everybody's dancing to Miley Cyrus's Party in the USA. It's just an all-around good time, man. Also, the barbecuing going on, the burgers, the hot dogs, the brisket, the chicken, all that good stuff, man. Like, 4th of July is just a solid middle of the summer holiday that everybody likes. And it is definitely one of the most good holidays out of the year, damn. And for our eighth entry is August. Nobody really likes August. It is literally like one of the most. Everyone thinks that December is the most stressful month of the year. No, August is. And I'll tell you why. Because August is when it's back to school season. It's back to school for high schools for the most part, unless you go back after Labor Day. It's back to school time for some colleges too. It is just, and that is one of the most nerve-wracking parts of the year, is August. Not to mention, there really no other holidays. I mean, the closest thing I can think of is that sometimes there's a solar eclipse. And so all my roller coaster enthusiasts out there, National Roller Coaster Day on August the 16th. Other than that, nothing else really goes on in August. We'll move it on. Next installment, and this next thing on our list is Labor Day, that brings up in September, and it is an alright holiday, you know, to celebrate the workers and people that do work out there, and they be putting that working all over the place. And it also gives you a nice three-day weekend, because your last holiday you got off was at the start of July the 4th. So here you are around the 5th, so almost 2 months without a break. So this is a much needed break, but really nothing else really about the holiday side, you know, maybe some cooking out and whatnot, maybe a little in the summer pool party. Other than that, it's just pretty much a nice little break in there between the 2 months. And also, everybody knows what the real holiday of September is. Yes, Earth, Wind, and Fire said it 40, almost 50 years ago, but it is the 21st night of September. That is the best day in freaking September, is the 21st night. Moving on. Now, this is what y'all all been waiting for. This is what everybody else been waiting for. The best, most goated holiday of the year is straight up in the 10th month of the year at the last possible day when people celebrate this, starting from the 14th down, and it is Halloween. And then everybody, that has to be one of the most S-tierest holidays around. Everybody loves Halloween, no matter what you are, bro. I mean, like, come on. Us straight guys, we love seeing the girls in the freaking tight costumes, the skimpy outfits, they hoeing it up. And you know, us guys, they love that. You know, us guys, we may put ourselves a little suit or a little costume on going, but it's mainly for the girls. They put you on the sexy Santa, well, not that, but like, they putting on the angel, they putting on the devil, they putting on the police, they putting on the dang, yeah, whatever else, but like, they just be putting on baddies. Oh yeah, my all-time favorite, the bodysuits, especially when she dressed up as She-Go. Ooh, man, that, oof. Plus all the damn October Halloween-ish / fall-ish decor. You know, it's usually not that hot out around this time of year. And also with mainly Halloween, also the candy too. And this is the holiday that everybody likes, and everybody just all around just can't wait to go. And it's like the one night where like you can be not yourself, and it's perfectly all right. That is one of the most goated holidays out there, and I wish it was federally recognized, because it is just goated all the way around. Like, who doesn't like Halloween, bro? Between the baddies, ooh, yeah. And then next up, we have the 11th month out of the year, which brings us two major holidays, but I think that the latter one gets more attention, and that is Thanksgiving Day, which to me, Thanksgiving has the same hype around Easter. I mean, it's okay. You get the Thursday off to eat dinner with your family and stuff, but like the main thing with it, with Thanksgiving, makes it really mid is the fact that it's always on a Thursday, and most people have to work the following Friday. So it's like you get the Thursday off, but then you gotta work Friday, but then you get the weekend off. In fact, that's actually the original reason for Black Friday. It wasn't about the shopping, it was mainly about how a lot of schedules would be blacked out the next day, as people would take that day off, whether it was paid or not. That way they would get a 4-day weekend instead of having one day off, having to work one day, and then 2 days off. So other than that, Thanksgiving is pretty much a mid-holiday, but you know, it's a nice little thingy to look forward to between Christmas and Halloween. Well, Halloween and Christmas. And for the last entry on this list, we saved pretty much almost the best for last, and it is Christmas Day. This is one of the most hyped up holidays of all time. Like, as us being in school, y'all already know when it was around end of November, December, Christmas time, that was the best. Literally every classroom would have like a little pot. You know, someone would bring in cookies, crackers, snakes, pies, probably some cake, you know, some sodas. We all sit around the tables. The teacher put on the Polar Express back in our younger years of schooling, and then towards the end of the year, we just got on our Chromebooks, we got to play with our phones. Some of us, if you're still in school or just graduated, if your grade was 80% or higher, then you got to exempt the EOC. And back in my school, we used to go to, they sent on people that were able to skip the AOC. The EOC, not the AOC. They sent them to either the gym and then later on to the cafeteria. So everybody would be in there playing Cards Against Humanity, Monopoly, Sorry, Brigands going crazy, people watching stuff on the Chromebooks, and all kinds of fun stuff and whatnot. And a lot of people, they ended up leaving early on that Friday before Christmas break. That Christmas break was crazy, because depending on how Christmas fell on this year, you almost got a full week before the holiday, depending on if Christmas was on like a Saturday, Sunday, or Monday. You would get off like the whole week before. And not to mention like putting up all the decorations, like that flashing behind me, that's actually my Christmas tree. In fact, I'm about to show y'all. Actually, I ain't gonna move my thingy, but there we go. But like that's what's flashing behind me is my Christmas tree. And you know, young, just like seeing all the presents slowly building up by the tree and whatnot, and then actually getting to open those. A lot of people, they be traveling for Christmas Day trying to see friends and family. You know, you might get a little something from your dang girl, or you might get a little something, or you might get a little something from your guy too. Who knows? I don't care what you're into, but like literally, Christmas is probably one of the most goated holidays out of the year, just because that and all the hype that builds up from it used to start around Black Friday and a little bit before, but now like you go to Hobby Lobby and they got Christmas stuff out in at the end of July. And then Christmas stuff starts getting into the stores halfway through October, so it almost beats out the dang Halloween stuff. But yeah, Christmas, and also some people's jobs give them extra days off on the holiday, and also some get a much-needed Christmas bonus to either see family, buy presents, or pay down bills. Like, it's just one of the most good holidays out there. But, yes, Christmas, that definitely is an S-tier holiday right there. And that concludes my video on every month's major holiday ranked. Be sure to drop down in the comments what your opinions are about what I said, if maybe I should have included a different holiday, or if you feel the same way about that holiday or whatnot. But yeah, definitely drop your opinions down in the comments. Don't forget to, like, comment, share, subscribe for the next one.